Renee, Anne, and Dusty. Appreciate your work in this. So when Cindy first came to me about this student video contest, I said to myself, that has my name written all over it. So I made my video, and then I thought to myself, oh God, what am I gonna say? Because I had no clue. So I started Googling about keynote speeches, what they're about, and I found tips about how to be a good keynote speaker, but nothing about what I should really say. So I started to ask myself, why did I fall in love with community health nursing? So my whole speech is about that. I actually got into community health at a very young age. I started working for Niagara Region Public Health at the age of 17, developing mental health promotion campaigns targeted towards youth. So I was part of a project called No Mental Health, No Stigma, about the addition of mental health education into the grade 9 physical health and education curriculum, because at the time, the curriculum hadn't been updated in 15 years, which means it was older than the students that were learning about it. From there, fast forward a year, I started working at the Central East Tobacco Control Area Network with Cindy Baker Broyle, and was able to work on a lot of amazing projects locally, regionally, and provincially, and really learned about how much nurses can have an impact on community health. And I actually developed a huge passion for community health nursing. And then this previous summer, I did spend my summer working in home care and gathered a huge respect for nurses that can go into someone else's home and deliver care right at the bedside, because it takes a lot to go out of your own safety net of that acute care setting and into someone else's home and focus on holistic care. So another little fact about me is, besides my passion for community health nursing, I do dabble a little bit in graphics. So I can't take credit for the artwork behind this. The students did come up with the concept. I just took it and ran with it. So I know that it's been a long day and I probably can't keep all of your attentions, but I tried to add a few animations and graphics to make this a little bit more entertaining, as you can see. So, when we go into nursing school, we have this preconceived idea of what it means to be a nurse, whether it be influenced from an experience you've had, someone in your family who's a nurse, or what we see in the media. We see nurses as those caring, compassionate individuals that are there with patients through the best and the worst times in their life. And I know, I forget who was discussing this, I believe it was the Healthy Schools, about being there through the best and the worst. And while this is true, you truly don't understand what it means to be a nurse until you're either deep into the nursing program or within the workplace. So, as students, we're taught about different nursing theorists like Watson, Parsi, and Nightingale. What all these theorists teach us is that we need to look at the whole picture. We need to look past that injury, the disease, or the diagnosis, and truly understand the lived experience. We try to understand the patient's life, or the individual's life. We want to understand their motivations, their values, and their goals. But we also want to understand what led them to our care. What is their diet? What is their exercise regime? What's their past medical history? What are their relationships like? What are those factors that really influence their health? But often when we as students or nurses out there, when we think of those nursing theorists, we think of that one-on-one perspective. We think that it has to be at the bedside in an acute care facility. But if there's anything that these nursing theorists have taught us, it's that you really need to understand your environment. For example, Nightingale, she was known as the Lady of the Lamp because during the Crimean War, here's a history lesson for you, I know you all know, but I'm just gonna review it. She would go around with a lamp in the trenches and take care of the soldiers. But she was also known as one of the first nursing theorists, and she developed the environment theory. So she saw about how the environment has an impact on health. And as she said, poor or difficult environments led to poor health and disease. But she also said that environments could be altered. She said that we as nurses can make those changes. So within her theory, she also talked about the fact about sanitation, about cleanliness and good air quality, and all the other environmental factors that influence health. And that's the great thing about community health nursing, is that we take that step back away from that one-on-one perspective, and we really look at the environment and how it affects health. We look at theories like the environmental theory, and we also look at social determinants of health to really understand how people go about living healthy lifestyles. What are those barriers or those gaps within the community, and how we can go about creating supports and changing healthy lifestyles. So by looking at social determinants of health, we look at things like access to healthy food, education, readily available resources like healthcare, access to healthcare. We discussed it today. It's a very complex healthcare system. And it is moving towards the community, and we do need to understand how to make those services more readily available to patients. We also look at income, gender, race, and affordable housing, and much more. But how do we go about making that change? Well, we do it through the Ottawa Charter of Health Promotion. So I know many of you have seen the diagram. It's this lovely flame-looking thing. But at the center of it are these three things. It's advocating, enabling, and mediating. Advocacy is all about being aware of the circumstances and your environment, really assessing, to understand what inequities and adversities that people are facing within your community. It's all about being conscious about the social inequities and the diversity that's within the population. We as nurses are the most trusted profession as seen by the public, so we have that perfect opportunity to go into the community, understand those gaps and those barriers, and advocate for change. We know what supports are needed to make a change. The next thing is about enabling. So once we are aware of those inequities, those gaps, and those barriers, we're able to create that supportive environment, whether it be through supports, education, resources, or other initiatives. We get to create that supportive environment to encourage people to make healthier life choices. We encourage them to take action towards their own health choices. So, stuck to the tape here. And the final one is mediating. So as we discussed throughout the whole day, it's a very complex healthcare system, especially when you move away from the acute care setting. So we as nurses have that job as coordinators or from CCAC to navigate that healthcare system and help patients get those resources that they really need. But if you can't focus on all of that, the whole idea behind the Ottawa Charter for Health Promotion is just equity. But what's the difference between equality and equity? Can anyone give me just a brief definition of what equality is? Exactly that. So I saw this diagram probably about 5 years ago at the training, and it stuck with me because I don't think I've ever seen a diagram that really shows what community health nursing does. Obviously 5 years ago I wasn't in community health nursing, but it stuck with me and it really did resonate. So as you said, equality is providing everyone with the exact same supports. No matter what their background or adversities that they face, we give them all the exact same supports and resources, and we expect them to be at the same level. But equity, on the other hand, is going into the community and really assessing, like I said, that key assessment skills and understanding the gaps and what we need to do to make a difference so everyone reaches that same level of health. It's really not about the distance traveled, it's about where you end up. And the great thing about community health nursing is our ability to step out of that acute care setting and focus on understanding your community. We have such an integral role in healthcare because we actually go on into the ground and we get to interact with our community. We get to really understand and we get to build relationships that other nurses don't get the chance to. And we get to make a change on a larger scale. So as a student, about 2 years ago, I had a professor introduce me to this amazing resource called the Community Toolbox from the University of Kansas. And it's been a great resource for me to really own in on my skills as a community health nurse. It teaches you everything from planning initiative, from engaging stakeholders, gathering funding, planning your goals and your strategies, implementing that initiative, and evaluating, because we all know evaluating is one of the most important things when you're doing initiative, because you can see the success and you can see where improvements need. So I encourage all the students to check it out. It's a really good resource. And skills. How many of you here have heard this? I'm scared if I work in the community, I will lose my skills. Yes, a lot. And I admit, I was one of those students where when I was really contemplating about where I want to be in my career, I said to myself, I am petrified that if I go into the community, I will lose those acute care skills. But I had someone say to me, and it actually really stuck with me, is that With community health nursing, there are so many opportunities that you can still do those acute care skills within the community. Whether you work in a clinic and home care, you have those skills and they go with you. But the most important skill that you can have is your assessment skill. That is the one thing as a nurse that you take with you. You are able to go into the community and assess, like I said, I keep repeating it, the barriers and the inequities that people face, and you assess the environment. And even when you work in home care, you go in and you're not in that familiar environment of a hospital. You're in a different situation. Your assessment skills are stronger than ever because you don't always have the supports that you need to deliver care. But also in the clinic, and everywhere else, of course. But I'm here to tell you is that your skills are not bound by the four walls of a hospital. Those skills will go with you wherever you go. Yeah, so inspirational, right? So as we learned today, I'm gonna keep it short. I don't wanna drag this on. I know you guys wanna go home for your Saturday. Oh, thank you so much. We learned about a lot of roles within the community that nurses may have. It's such a diverse profession, nursing, but really it's even more diverse when you go into the community. We're so limited when we're in an acute care setting. We just have our patients and those four walls and whatever supplies we need, but in the community, we're more resourceful. We create campaigns that just don't happen on a local level. They happen on a provincial level, like Queen's Park. Actually, just like Carol Timmons was saying, is having that more, that population perspective, looking at more of the bigger picture, and also on the national level. We as nurses are a political powerhouse. We make changes that no other professional body does, and especially as community health nurses, because we are really on the ground making that difference and understanding our community. So who better to make those changes? So the bigger picture, this is actually my final slide, because I just wanted to take the time to really thank everyone for the opportunity, and thank the planning committee, because what a better profession to be in. We are able to come to events like these and really connect with each other and share knowledge, and that is what nursing is all about. It's about that evidence-based practice. It's about connecting with one another and making a difference. So once again, thank you to the planning committee, thank you to Shanig, and thank you to all of you for coming here on a Saturday. I don't know if you have questions for me, but I have a slide there. Yeah.
Small token of our appreciation for you for all the effort. I know it was hard to fit this into all of your busy schedule, and I'm so proud that you did. It's gonna make me cry. And I didn't vote for him. I abstained from voting, just so you know, because I do know him, but I would have voted for him if I was voting. We did have some very good quality videos. So that takes us to the end of the day, and we aren't going to use my slide, but it's to remind us to do the evaluation. So if you